select all, go to tools, array, and we want to make the copy on the x-axis. So we will say make a copy 100 generic units next to this guy, and we want 10 copies, and the type of copy will be instance. So I'll hit OK, and look what we did. It just created 10 copies right next to each other on the x-axis. I'll hit G on my keyboard to get rid of the grid. I'll go to my top viewport, and now we are going to create the actual track. For that, we are going to use a plane primitive. For the width, it's going to be 1000, because, and it's going to be 1000 because one of these guys over here is 100 centimeter, and we made 10 copies. And 10 into 100 means 1000, so this guy's width is going to be 1000. And now I'm going to move it to the origin. Hit Ctrl A, deselect the track. I'll say group, and whatever you want to call it. I'll move to the origin. I'll line this up. I'll check this in my perspective viewport. I'll select this and say group, ungroup, because I don't like the process of grouping. You can leave it group if you want. Now I'll come back to my track. For the length segments, it's going to be 2. And now I'm going to convert this to an ideal poly object. Take this loop and move it over. And basically, all these guys over here are going to be our track, and these guys over here are going to be our grass area right next to the track. So we only need 2 segments for that, and the rest of DLA is going to come from the materials. So I'll hit zoom extends. Now I'm going to say Ctrl A, select all, deselect the track, activate my angle snaps, and I'm going to rotate it 25 degrees. I'll take the track, go to the polygon mode, take this guy, and rotate it 25 degrees as well. I'll take these words and move them down, and we want this to be completely straight, so I'll select both of these vertices, all of these vertices over here, and hit make them planar on the z-axis. Now I'll go back to my left viewport and line this up. And basically, the whole technique of this track, of this tutorial, is that anything that we want to place on the side of the track, we are going to place it over here. Select all of them, hit Ctrl A to select them, and say bend. And we are going to apply the bend modifier. X is going to be X, angle is going to be 360, and direction is going to be 90. And that's going to be on the side of our track. But here you can see the track is very blocky. And to fix that, I'm going to undo a couple of steps until I get rid of the bend modifier. I'll select this guy, go to the edge mode. I'll say loop, ring, and now I'm going to connect it to add some extra resolution so that it bends smoothly. And we want 20 edges on this guy. I'll select the rings, and we want 10 edges on this guy. And now, if you're going to select all of them and apply the bend modifier, not camera map, I mean bend. Free 60, 90. So now the result is very smooth, as we accepted. I'm going to collapse the stack. I'll select the track only and isolate it, hitting Control A, Control plus Q, Alt plus Q on my keyboard. Sorry. Now we are going to fix some of our problems that the bend modifier created. As you can see, these vertices over here are not welded, so we are going to weld them. I'll select them. I'll go down. Now I'll say weld, dial the threshold up and say OK. Now I'm going to check that if they are welded. And now you can see they are welded. The other problem that we have over here is that we have a big hole in the center of the cross season. So we are going to select the border and say collapse. And basically, these guys over here are the grass season, and all these guys over here are going to be our track. So I'll scale down the grass season because we don't want it to be so wide. I'll go to my top viewport, select these guys. Now I'm going to detach them and call it grass. Go back to my top level, like this guy. Give it an appropriate color. Select this guy and give it another color that's appropriate for our track. Now I'm going to call it track. So now I'm going to exit the isolation mode. So I'll hit Control A and scale these guys on any one of the axes. Not any one, but X or Y. Because I don't want a completely circular result. Okay, so that's pretty much it for this lesson. In the next lesson, we are going to start the process of texturing the racetrack. So don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button below, and I'll see you guys next time.